Hi and welcome back to the channel. In this video we're going to find out whether you can actually use Hozelock AquaStop connectors on the hosepipe connected to a pressure washer. Do they actually restrict flow or damage the pressure washer? Let's find out.
If you're not familiar with AquaStop connectors, the main benefit is being able to disconnect the hose from the pressure washer to connect it to something else without water going everywhere or having to turn the tap off first. To perform this test, I'm going to be using my Karcher K4 and I've bought a brand new hose pipe, two standard hose end connectors and two AquaStop connectors. Most pressure washer manufacturers recommend a minimum hose pipe length of 7.5 metres. I've bought a 15 metre hose as that is usually the starting length of hose pipes. I've got a standard 10 litre bucket with measurements on the inside. I've coloured the 10 metre mark to make it easier to see in the video. First test is to see how fast I can fill a bucket straight from the tap. Which equates to 18.6 litres per minute, or 1,115 litres an hour. Now let's see what the hosepipe can do with standard connectors on both ends. These connectors are a little tricky to get on for the first time. The internal diameter of this hosepipe is 12.5 millimetres, which is the standard half inch most hosepipes use. Before I time it, I'm first going to prime the hosepipe to remove any air from inside it. So the hose pipe with standard connectors took nearly 44 seconds, which equates to 13.7 litres per minute or 820 litres per hour. The hose pipe has restricted flow by nearly a third when compared to the tap on its own. Now I'm going to test the hose pipe with AquaStop connectors on both ends. Because water doesn't flow through AquaStop connectors unless you have it connected to something, I'm removing the connector from the pressure washer to attach it to the end of the hose pipe so it simulates water flow as if it was connected to the pressure washer. Again, I'm removing air from the hose pipe before starting. The hosepipe using AquaStop connectors took nearly 53 seconds to fill the 10 litre bucket, which equates to 11.4 litres per minute or 683 litres per hour. When compared to the standard hose connectors, AquaStop connectors have reduced flow through the hosepipe by about 18%, 13.7 litres per minute down to 11.4. Before we draw conclusions from that, let's now test each connector type with the pressure washer, as that will be the true test. I'll first start with the standard connectors. I'm first going to remove any air in the high pressure hose or pump. There's so much air in that it looks like milk. I'm not attaching the lance head for this test because we want to test the maximum possible flow of the pressure washer pump. One minute and 32 seconds to fill the 10 litre bucket, which works out at 6.5 litres per minute or 390 litres per hour. This means the K4 pressure washer at maximum flow is using less than half the potential flow of the hose pipe with standard connectors attached. Now let's run the same test with the AquaStop connectors on both ends. Quick bleed to remove any air from the system, and away we go. It's difficult to stop bang on the 10 litre mark with the turbulence created from the pressure washer, so once it has settled, I'll top it up if needed. One minute and 33 seconds to fill 10 litres with AquaStop connectors. That's a second more than the standard hosepipe connectors, but this is less than 1% difference and is most likely down to me not measuring out the 10 litres precisely. Calculating the flow rate with AquaStop connectors works out at the same 6.5 litres per minute or 390 litres per hour as the standard connectors. This is because it is the pressure washer that is restricting flow, not the hosepipe or AquaStop connectors. The maximum flow of the hosepipe with AquaStop connectors is 11.4 litres per minute. This K4 is using 6.5 litres per minute, or 57% of the potential max of this hosepipe setup. These tests are based on the pressure washer's maximum flow, when in fact you don't use it like that when cleaning the patio or washing the car. So now let's see what the flow is like if we restrict it with the lance head attached. I'm going to use a bigger bucket to reduce how much spray is kicked up from the lance. Using the 10 litres measured out in the last test, I'm pouring it into this Meguiar's bucket so I can make a 10 litre marking on the inside. And away we go again. One minute 47 seconds, which equates to 5.6 litres per minute or 335 litres per hour. So with the lance head attached, the pressure washer is only using half of the potential max of the AquaStop hosepipe setup. Here is the table containing all the tests I've run and the calculations for water flow. Now different pressure washers have different flow rates, so I've compiled a table showing all of the current Karcher models with their maximum stated flow rates. Now you can see here, the Karcher K7 is the only one that specifies a minimum water input flow rate that exceeds what the AquaStop hosepipe setup can provide. However, the maximum flow rate is still under the max AquaStop hosepipe rate, and Karcher are basing this on max flow, which the pressure washer can only achieve when the lance head is disconnected and nobody uses it this way. Based on these tests, I have no doubts in using the AquaStop connectors with my Karcher pressure washer. Do you still have doubts? If so, please comment to let me know if I missed something in testing that might draw a different conclusion. Some might be thinking, what about the pump sucking in the AquaStop valve and shutting off flow to the pressure washer? Well, that's not possible either. When the AquaStop is connected to the tap connector, the valve inside is pressed against it, so it's physically impossible to shut it. To do that, the hosepipe would have to pop off the tap connector at the same time. If you find your pressure washer is doing this during use, it's likely it's been starved of water. If you're using AquaStop connectors, then there are two things to check. Firstly, run a similar test as I did with and without AquaStop connectors to make sure water flow through your hosepipe is sufficient for your pressure washer. Secondly, old or worn AquaStop connectors might not provide the same flow rate as new ones, so they might need replacing.
Well guys, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Subscribing's free, and it just means any future videos I release will automatically appear on your feed without you having to search for them. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.